ASX Small and Mid-Cap Conference this morning. Cyril Desouza from Bigtincan. Cyril, morning.
Morning, Andrew. I'm pleased to be here.
Good to see you, Cyril. In simple terms here, just firstly, tell us a bit about what Bigtincan does.
So Bigtincan is a ASX company that's basically specializes in sales enablement software. And basically what we do is we help customer-facing people be more successful in increasing their revenue lines in today's world of remote and digital economy. So it's basically improving the productivity of the salespeople.
Tell us a bit more about who some of your clients and customers are.
Yeah, so we've actually got 100 of the top 500 Fortune customers. So they include Nike, Sephora, T-Mobile, Major League Baseball, and Citibank, to name a few. So we've got a wide range of customers. Within the Australian market, we've got Seek, Breville, Optus, and Lion, to name a few.
Now, full year 23, a significant year for the business, culminating in cash flow breakeven in the fourth quarter. Tell us a bit more about the year itself.
Yeah, so the year was one of transition. So Bigtincan has been growing substantially since the post-IPO in April 2017, growth rates of in excess of 20%. But in FY23, we transitioned to more of a value-based company on the focus on profitability. And that's evident by the increase in the adjusted EBITDA, which went from 4.1 million in FY22 to 8.3 million at the end of FY23. In terms of cash flow breakeven, it occurred within the fourth quarter of FY23, and we feel that's sustainable going into FY24. And that is the result of some of the cost adjustments that we made throughout the year. Just to give a bit more detail, in Q1 of FY23, our cost outflow was 40 million. At the end of Q4 FY23, that reduced to 31 million. So we've got a base or a run rate going into this year that we're quietly confident about.
Well, tell us a bit more, what are your expectations as far as growth in full year 24?
Growth is always an emphasis in terms of the business, and we feel that growth can be achieved with our multi-hub strategy that we've been rolling out with the platforms that we've got. That's a focus that we've got with our sales team within North America. And we see the market, the sales enablement market, still being very positive, despite a bit of a slowdown in some of the tech companies that we experienced in the second half of FY23. But going forward, the business is focused on growing that top line, but also managing our costs in a prudent manner.
How important are acquisitions for you?
Acquisitions are important to generate the platform that we've got in use, and that helped us with the content hub, the engagement hub, and also the learning hub that all form the one platform that we sell to our customers. The learning hub was transformative with the BrainShark acquisition that was made in August 2021, which basically doubled the size of the business. So we see it's essential in accelerating the roadmap for the business. But in terms of going forward into FY24, there's no real acquisition in the pipeline, because we feel the platform that we have at the moment is self-sufficient to generate the necessary growth that we need going forward.
Well, Cyril, just for a prospective investor, perhaps, how would you summarise the investment case in Bigtincan?
The Bigtincan business is fantastic from the position of a very diversified vertical market. We've got historical growth rates that we've achieved that we can achieve going forward. We've got a very solid SaaS platform where 90% of our revenue is recurring, and the business is well adjusted in terms of the costs that we made throughout FY23, but also some of the adjustments we announced on the ASX on Friday in terms of this FY24 period. So the business is well placed to improve with the technology it has at the moment to get that long-term shareholder value.
Good to speak, Cyril. Thanks for your time.
Thanks, Andrew. Appreciate it.